Hi, I'm Knierim from CKTV. I've just come out of watching The Diving Madman, starring Jeffrey Rush and Yael Stone. Yael Stone played three parts in this two-actor play. She played the love interest, the maid, and also the mentally unstable patient in the asylum. Now, this play was a very good play and very interesting, and she's allowed us to be able to interview her today.
Welcome to the program again. It's very nice having you here.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
So how challenging was it playing three very diverse roles?
As challenging as you make it, I guess. You just have to work hard enough and do enough research. It's a great blessing to have three different characters.
In the play, or in the role, you had to shave your head.
Mm-hmm. You noticed? Good.
You had to shave your head. And do you feel as if that was a difficult decision to make, losing your long brunette curls or locks?
Yeah, I guess if you're kind of really interested in what you're doing and you're willing to make some sacrifices, you just decide where you're going to draw the line and what kind of sacrifices you're going to make.
Do you feel as if you've lost some of your identity outside the theatre?
No, I probably just gained a new one.
Now, in this play, there's a scene in the play where the madman is going to be taken away by the nurses, mm-hmm. and your character is trying desperately for him to understand the gravity of this situation. Mm-hmm. You have tears in your eyes, mm-hmm. real tears. Mm-hmm. How did you do that?
I guess it's not so much the doing, it's the investing and the process that leads up to that point. So in the doing of it, I'm kind of looking for as little awareness as possible, really.
So no onions.
No onions. But I'm hoping that it's not about that kind of proof. It's more about the use of text and really trying to communicate and really
coming into the play.
Yeah, and making it as intimate as it is for Jeffrey and I, but for everyone that's in the auditorium, whether you're in row A or, you know,
you've worked with some of Australia's greatest artists, from Rachel Griffith in the film Me, Myself and I, mm-hmm. when you were just 14 years old, my age, mm-hmm. and also in a couple of mini-series like All Saints. Mm-hmm. How have they influenced your performance?
I've worked with lots of wonderful actors and lots of wonderful directors and designers and musicians, and I think people outside your professional life are really interesting influences as well. In terms of working within the profession, you get to kind of test ideas with people, and there's this huge amount of learning that happens along the way, and sometimes it can't really be defined, and sometimes it's more a process of osmosis and understanding a professional approach, a delicate approach and a sensitive approach, and those are probably the things I've learned.
In 2008, you won two awards for the Sydney Theatre Awards, and in 2010, you've been nominated for a Helton Award and a Sydney Theatre Award. Mm-hmm. Will you, like many Australian actors, make your way to the US to seek fame and fortune?
I don't think that's something you can plan. I'm not the kind of girl that would plan that. I'm really happy here.
Thank you. It's been wonderful talking to you after the show.
It is my pleasure. I'd love to talk to you as well.
Sweet heaven.